take a look now at today's New York Times op-ed by Warren Buffett. That headline is sure to fuel the debate over taxing the rich. Wealth reporter Robert Frank knows a thing or two about that, and he's here with one, what would you say, important problem with the Buffett
plan? A caveat, a little bit of context to help inform this debate. Now, the premise of the Buffett rule and this op-ed is that the rich pay a lower tax rate than the rest of America. In this op-ed, he points out that half of America's top 400 earners, they pay a rate of less than 20%. That's far less than the official top tax rate of 35%. Now, the Buffett rule, he said, would restore fairness. It would make those making $1 million or more pay at least 30% in an effective tax rate. Now, what we fail to mention here, what he fails to mention, is that the rich already pay a higher rate than the rest of the population when you look nationally. The effective tax rate, that's the amount that people actually pay, it averages 20.4% for people making $1 million or more. Now, people making $30,000 to $50,000, they pay an average rate of 4.8%. Now, people who make between $50,000 and $100,000, they pay 7.8%. The IRS data here is very clear. The more you make, the higher your effective rate. This sounds obvious, but the Buffett rule implies the opposite. Now, this doesn't include state, local, and payroll taxes. And yes, there are cases where some super rich guy like Buffett pays a lower rate than his secretary, but they are the outliers. Only a third of million-dollar earners would actually pay the Buffett tax, since most of them, they already pay at least 30%. So I'm not saying the Buffett rule is a bad idea, but its value and the problem that it solves are largely symbolic. Again, I don't take a view on taxes one way or the other, just to better inform this debate.
Robert, hey, it's Brian Sullivan. I want to jump in on that because I like the point you're making, because there's so much misconception out there. Both my parents do taxes for a living, one corporate, one individual. I like what you're pointing out. And what also needs to be pointed out is that if you make $75,000 a year, have two kids, and own a home, there's a great likelihood you pay zero in net effective federal income tax. Yes, you pay payroll taxes, and a lot of people forget that. You know, you'll hear people say, well, the rich don't only pay this, but they also pay the payroll taxes and state taxes, which have gone up over time as well. Again, not defending it. I've argued for the Buffett rule, but we need to be clear that, and as the USA Today pointed out last year, I think it was, about 500,000 households making $100,000 a year paid zero in net effective after deduction federal income taxes the year before.
That's right. No, it's a very important point. I think people would do themselves a service, and accountants would do us a service, if at the end of April we all figured out what percentage we actually pay, so when we saw Warren Buffett or Mitt Romney paying 14-17%, we would know what everyone actually pays.
Okay, fantastic stuff. Thank you very much.